I love Minority Report. I love the setting, I love the technology, and originally I wanted to do a video exploring how perfectly the Spielberg classic encapsulated our technological future. I mean, this movie predicted targeted ads in 2002. But the more I researched, the more I noticed how relevant the themes of the movie are to conversations we still have today. So, while I still hope to do a video comparing Minority Report's technology to our own, for this video, I want to examine why and how Minority Report still feels relevant, even now. And where better to start than with a quick recap of the film's plot. For those of you who don't know, Minority Report is a 2002 film directed by Steven Spielberg and starring 40-year Cinema Marathon gold medalist Tom Cruise. The plot takes place in a futuristic DC in the year 2054, where the police have established a pre-crime department for finding and arresting criminals before they commit any crimes. They do so with precogs, which are basically mutant humans who can see the future. When two or more precogs see the same future, that is considered enough evidence to warrant an arrest. Seriously think about how dystopian that is. Anyone could be arrested and charged with a crime they have yet to commit and with almost no evidence. Now, I don't want to spoil more than I have to, but everything really kicks off when Tom's character, pre-crime chief John Anderton, is charged with a crime he is yet to commit and, as a result, goes on the run to clear his name. This act introduces the philosophical debate at the core of the story. By knowing his future, does Anderton have the free will to choose not to commit his future crime, an act that by its definition would undermine pre-crime's very existence? Or is his chosen future
inevitable?
That plot alone is perfection, but when the film came out, it also felt extremely timely because the US was still healing from 9/11, and as a result, many of the themes reflected ongoing debates around expanding government powers. Now, a little history. In the wake of September 11, 2001, the US government, particularly the Bush administration, reacted to the attacks by demanding more power to fight terrorism. This culminated in the signing of the USA Patriot Act on October 26, 2001, a little over a month after the attacks. In case you didn't know, the USA Patriot Act is actually an acronym. It stands for Uniting and Strengthening America by providing appropriate tools required to intercept and obstruct terrorism. In addition to the crazy title, the act had three main provisions that drastically expanded government powers for the purposes of fighting terrorism both at home and abroad. 1. Expand abilities of law enforcement to surveil, including tapping domestic and international phones. Because, you know, this is 2001. 2. Eased interagency communication to enable agencies to more effectively use all available resources in counterterrorism efforts. Basically, making it easier for agencies to share information about potential threats to America. And finally, 3. Increase penalties for terrorism crimes and an expanded list of activities which would qualify someone to be charged with terrorism, thereby lowering the bar for what constituted terrorism. The act was so controversial not just from the vague ways in which it expanded government power, but also because it was so rushed that many of those who voted on it, especially those who voted for it, had yet to actually read the act they were going to vote on. In a way, I always felt the Patriot Act informed a lot of the themes of Minority Report. I mean, being able to charge and detain individuals with a crime on little to no evidence still sounds eerily familiar. But the more I researched, the more I learned that the movie's entire creation was not influenced by the events of 9/11 in any way. Just a quick aside about the film. Spielberg had originally wanted to direct Cruise in a film ever since they worked together on Risky Business. When Cruise read John Cohen's screenplay for Minority Report, he was so excited he passed it along to Spielberg. And by 1998, Spielberg was satisfied with the revisions and signed on to the film, expressing his excitement in how the mystery story mixed with the futuristic setting allowed for a blending of genres. And all the while, Spielberg was meeting with scientists to get a sense of what a plausible 2054 Washington DC might look like based on the technologies and trends of the early 2000s. What I'm getting at is that despite being filmed before 9/11, the film feels so prophetic, not because of any specific technology, but because of how well the source material encapsulates a never-ending tug of war all citizens have with their government. And believe it or not, this is where the video gets big brain. For anyone who doesn't know, again, Minority Report was originally a short story published in 1956 by Philip K. Dick. Most of the beats from the story and film are the same. Precogs, Anderton being framed, the questionable reality of pre-crime. Though Spielberg did a lot to update the story visually and technologically, the biggest changes come in the story's climax. In the film, Anderton is framed in order to secure pre-crime's place as an infallible law enforcement institution, culminating in his innocence and the end of pre-crime. However, the original short story actually goes hard in the other direction, revealing that Anderton was framed by a general who wanted to undermine pre-crime's existence while securing more funding and power for his own militaristic solution to the crime problem. I know this is already way too appropriate, but Dick's original story actually had far less to do with our current political climate than that of his own. Another quick history lesson for anyone who doesn't know, American politics during the 40s and 50s was pretty much defined by McCarthyism. It was a practice named for Senator Joseph McCarthy, in which individuals would be accused of subversion or treason without proper regard for evidence in the name of rooting out communism in the US. While Spielberg's Minority Report feels like a reaction to the Patriot Act, Dick's original story is a clear imagining of a future where McCarthyism is mainstream thanks to technologies like precogs. And this is where I need to gush about how well both the story and the film use technology to get you to buy into their versions of the future. While I think Spielberg's film feels the most real, both the film and the story present plausible dystopias that closely mirror our own reality, and they succeed because of how recent innovations in their reality, like the precogs, help normalize this new brand of law enforcement. I don't expect Spielberg or Dick could have imagined how much an act of terrorism could accelerate these events. And yet the story is still so timeless because it is grounded in an ongoing power struggle that seeks to balance our individual desires for freedom and self-determinism with our collective desire for safety and security. A struggle that those in power are willing to exploit to expand their reach and control. And I think this actually gets at the heart of what makes great sci-fi feel timeless. Sure, you can have all the hover cars and starships you like, but great sci-fi examines our humanity and uses technology and events to highlight how those imbalances can be exploited to the detriment of the very people they're intended to protect. And that's also why I think Minority Report will always feel relevant, because the story poses questions that will always be relevant, regardless of how we choose to update it. I just hope we learn those lessons before it's too late. With all that in mind, let me know what you think. Do you agree? Disagree? Do you have examples of sci-fi perfectly predicting our present? Leave a comment below, and I'll see you next time. Also, as if you needed more reason to watch this movie, the music is by Johnny Duel of the Fates Williams.